Hello everybody, this is Alex from SoyaChinChow.com and we're at Mobile World Congress 2019 and we're in the Sony booth right now to check out the new Xperia 1 and this is the latest flagship from Sony Mobile. Before we begin this video, I'd like to give a huge thanks to our roaming and innovation partner Digi for making our coverage of MWC 2019 possible. Enjoy borderless connectivity with Digi's affordable roaming plans from as low as 5 ringgit per day and manage them all easily with the MyDigi app even when you're overseas. Learn more in the link in the video description. So the Sony Xperia 1, so this is the latest flagship and Sony has really killed off the Xperia XZ range. So instead of coming out with the XZ4, we have the Xperia 1. And boy, it's a tall device. So this device, like the other Xperia devices that's announced recently, comes with a tall 21:9 aspect ratio. So this gives you like a cinematic view compared to your typical 18:9 smartphones. So in front you get a 4K display. There's a stretches at 6.5 inches and it's an OLED panel and Sony is calling this the world's first smartphone to come with a 4K OLED display. When I first saw this device, I was thinking to myself, this is too tall for anyone to use. I mean, it's a 21:9 aspect ratio. It's much taller than your typical 18:9. But once I get my hands on it, it's actually quite practical. I mean, Sony has put a lot of thought into the placement of the buttons. And if we compare it with the Galaxy Note 9, which has a 6.4 inch screen, the buttons are actually about the same area. So you have a power button right below here, a fingerprint sensor and a rocker button. So it's in the right spot. I can use it in one hand. Probably the only issue is the notification bar. So it's quite tall at the top. So you're gonna need to, you know, reach out to the top to really drag it down. Other than that, I have no issues with it. And yes, it still comes with a dedicated camera button like the previous Sony Xperia models. So Sony comes out with this display because they want you to experience cinematic content. So you can get 21:9 content videos on Netflix. But on YouTube, I guess most of the content is still 16:9 and only a handful of creators are switching to the 18:9 format. But what I can tell you is that this taller display does have its own benefits when it comes to multitasking. So a lot of phones can do multi-window, but on this one, if you do multi-window, you have enough real estate to display the on-screen keyboard and also the two other apps. So this is great if you're going to reply to WhatsApp messages while watching a video content at the same time. So moving on to the design, this Xperia 1 feels very premium. You got this solid metal frame. It's quite similar to the Xperia Z3. So there's no like a curved bulge at the bottom. So it's flat at the front, flat at the back, and it feels pretty solid in the hands. And another thing you might be wondering, why is Sony having a separate power button if there is already a fingerprint sensor? Because most manufacturers, they actually integrate them both together. And we are told that the reason why they do this is because of patent issues in the United States. So if you recall, on some earlier Xperia flagship models, they couldn't offer the fingerprint sensor on the power button because of those patent issues. So they mitigate that by having it separated. That's quite weird, but oh wait, it works. So in terms of protection, you get Gorilla Glass 6 for both front and back, so that could resist a couple of drops. If you look at the bottom here, it has a USB Type-C port with no headphone jack. In terms of audio entertainment, so you have stereo speakers, but it's not the same kind as you get on the previous Sony Xperia models, because this time it uses the top earpiece and the down-firing speakers. And this time Sony has added a Dolby Atmos enhancement to give that more immersive sound experience. So for the new Sony Xperia 1, Sony is actually jumping onto the triple camera bandwagon like most other flagships. So all three are shooting at 12 megapixels, so you get a normal main camera, an ultra wide angle shooter, and also a telephoto camera that gives you 2x optical zoom. And since Sony is banging on the cinematic experience, so you can actually capture your own cinematic video content with this cinematic pro mode. So that gives you the flexibility to add those cinema layers. You can shoot 4K videos with HDR at 24 frames per second. And for shooting videos, you can expect steadier shots because it uses a hybrid OIS and EIS system. I'm pretty sure that this will work very well because in my past experience with Sony devices, the steady shot is crazy steady. And it's, you know, it's almost magical. So in terms of specs, the Sony Xperia 1 has all the top of the line stuff. You get Snapdragon 855 processor with 6GB of RAM and 128GB of storage. And on top of that, it also retains a microSD expansion slot. So that's great if you want to add more storage. And the device also comes with IP68 water resistance, which is typical of a Sony flagship. But surprisingly, the battery is quite small for a 4K display smartphone. It's only 3300 mAh, and right now it charges via USB-C PD that's included in the box. Another surprising omission is the lack of wireless charging support.
I mean, the previous Sony Xperia XZ2 comes with wireless charging, but this one doesn't have it, and we're told that the reason why they remove it is to ensure that it has a slimmer profile. I don't know about you, but I think wireless charging is something that should be standard on most smartphones these days because it's super convenient. You can charge anywhere without carrying a cable. Overall, I think the Xperia 1 is an interesting device. The touch screen is actually better than I thought. The build quality is premium. The camera, unfortunately, we couldn't try it out because this is a demo unit, but it looks promising overall. In terms of availability, Sony Mobile has told us that this will be available by end of May. But when it comes to Malaysia, I don't think we'll be getting this device anytime soon because if you follow our news, it seems that Sony Mobile has exited the Southeast Asian market, and the last device they sold in Malaysia was the Xperia XZ2 Premium. So if you're thinking of getting this device, you probably got to look out for your great importers who might bring in AP sets.
Thanks to Airbnb for making us feel at home in beautiful Barcelona during MWC 2019. Book online today and get your very own stay-in experience at your next travel destination. Learn more in the link in the video description.
So that's it. So that's just a quick look at the Xperia 1, a new flagship with a 21:9 4K OLED display at Mobile World Congress 19. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up, like us on Facebook, subscribe to us on YouTube channel and hit the notification bell icon so that you'll be informed of our new video. Don't forget to check out our latest video here and also our Mobile World Congress 19 coverage over here. Thank you so much and see you next one. Bye!